Good day, YouTube, and welcome to another episode of the Albino Rhino Beer Review. Today you have the rhino, and we're going to look at a beer.
Fancy that, eh?
Yeah, we're going to look at a beer from a package sent to me by the one and only Ben, so thank you very much, Ben. Which one of his beers that he sent me do I want to do today? I'll do this one, from Red Line Brewing Company. This is 5.5% alcohol and 33 IBUs. This is the Lead Sled Oatmeal Stout. So Red Line's Lead Sled Oatmeal Stout. Brewed and packaged at Red Line Brew House. And store cold, drink fresh, drink responsibly. RedLineBrewHouse.com. 431 Bayview, Unit 8 and 9 in Barrie, Ontario. Alrighty, now, recently, Guy, and I believe his cousin Pascal, did a beer review with what the Trollmerica, average Trollmerica, Joseph, called the biggest troll glasses in the world. He was like, you know what, these are even more trolly than Big E and his Z-stems or Z-stems. And I decided to take those vampire glasses, because that's what they were. They were vampire glasses. And I found one even more trollish than the vampire glass. But we'll show you that in 1 second. So here we go. Black as black can be. Nice deep brown head. Big bubbles. Little snap, crackle, pop. Anyway, to go on to take Guy's vampire glass one step further, I found a little port sipper. So there you go. It's basically the vampire glass, but made to only hold 2.5 ounces. And yeah, a lot smaller. I think this is the true beer snob. This is the true beer snob fucking troll glass right here. Actually, the best smell comes from the can and the port sipper. Sweet, roasty. You get that oatmeal in there, adding a nice little sweetness as well to the nose. The roastiness is big and bold. There's a little bit of caramel. You get a little bit of the hops coming out of the big old glass. Kind of smells like it's a maybe I'd play some tunes, but it doesn't want to work. Kind of smells sort of like your average like stout hops, you know, just a little bitter, a little earthy, almost Magnum like. Let's try the beer. Gone. Good thing I have a big glass. Flavor-wise, you're looking at your average oatmeal stout. I mean, it's not a explosively different beer or anything like that. It's not super challenging. But this is what you kind of want in an oatmeal stout. This is a just very approachable, very easy drinking stout. The oats are there and they add this beautiful mouthfeel, of this creamy mouthfeel, as well as this nice sweetness that just balances all the way through. There's a nice caramel taste there. The roast is huge. The roast mixes with the hops to leave a slightly earthen, slightly almost like a burnt coffee bitterness in the back end. heavy beer, full-bodied. And a lot of beers lately have been, like, a lot of stouts lately I've had have been, like, medium to full. This is full. That's a nice beer. It's a nice beer. And it doesn't have that, slightly metallic taste that some oatmeal stouts give off. And I'm just talking about, like, a twinge right at the end you get from some of them. Well, at least I get from some of them. This one doesn't have it, and that makes this even nicer, too. I've only had two beers from Redline, and I'm excited for them. These guys are the real deal. This is a new brewery, an up-and-coming brewery, that is worth going out of your way to try. And the greatest thing is, if you're in Barrie, you have Flying Monkeys, Barnstormer, and these guys, and all three of them make some great beers. And it's not like Barrie's a huge city. I mean, it's a city. It's a large city compared to some places, but it's not huge. You can get to all three of these places fairly easily, and that just makes it even better for the people of Barrie. Out of 10 on this, excuse me, 8.5, I'm going to give it an 8.5. This is a really nice oatmeal stout. Almost, pretty much spot on to the BGCP, if that's what you want to follow. Tasting notes, pretty much spot on. Great little stout. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you, Ben, for sending this beer out. Bye-bye. I got to pull you close. You're too far away. Boop.